This morning we'll go over general weed control in sweet potato. Now when you look at weed management in different crops, different row crops, such as soybean, corn, cotton, and even rice, how they differentiate mainly from that weed management in a sweet potato crop is that you have numerous options. In those particular crops, you either have single products that you can use, or you're allowed to also tank mix a bunch of those together, thereby expanding the options that you have. In sweet potato, we're pretty much limited to about a handful of products that we can use. You see here to my left, down here, kind of gives you an idea of some of the weeds that we deal with. We have, you know, with the little white flowers, this is carpet weed. We have nutsedge right here. This is purple nutsedge we have in this particular plot here, but yellow nutsedge is the predominant nutsedge that we have. We have this light lime green colored weed that is ground cherry, which is a problem for us. Another big problem that we don't have in this particular field is smell melon that we have to deal with. A lot of annual grasses that we deal with, barnyard grass, brown top millet, broadleaf signal grass. Another broadleaf we have is slender amaranth. So we have a number of broadleaf and grass weeds we deal with. And again, like I mentioned earlier, our options are very limited. For broadleaf weed control in a sweet potato crop, we currently have no options that can effectively take out any emerged broadleaves. In other words, any broadleaves that go ahead and break through the soil and emerge after we plant the crop. We at one time had a product which we could apply, which gave us some decent broadleaf activity and really good activity on the purple and yellow nutsedge. We no longer have that. So for control of broadleaves in a sweet potato crop, we rely on the application of two herbicides before we plant. Because if you apply it after we plant the transplant, the sweet potato crop, we will have some severe injuries. So we have to apply those before we plant. Those two products are Valor, which has been labeled for a number of years, and Reflex, which has just been labeled a year now. This is the second year we're able to use it. Both of these are what we call PPO herbicides. In other words, they control the weed. The way they act on a weed to control it are very much the same. When you look at the spectrum of weeds they control, they do a pretty good job on most of the broadleaves that I mentioned previously. They will control pigweeds, they control morning glory, they will control the carpet weed, they will control the ground cherry. Both of them do a very good job, probably an equal job on those particular weeds. Where they separate each other is with nutsedge. With Valor, you're not going to get the nutsedge control that you are going to get with the Reflex. Now we put Reflex at a lower rate than we do in other crops, a pint versus a pint and a half, 2 pints in other crops. So the residual activity you're going to get on the nutsedge is not going to be what it would be at those higher rates, but you do get some hold back of that nutsedge. And as I mentioned, there's nothing we can put over the top of the sweet potatoes to control the nutsedge once it emerges. We do have another product I'll mention in a little bit that does provide us some nutsedge activity. So we do have a 1-2 punch, but just from a soil residual standpoint, nothing that control them once they've emerged. So we apply one of these two products out prior to transplanting. Now, once we apply these out, we have to run the mechanical transplanter over the crop, over the rows, and actually plant the slips within the ground. We don't plant seed like we do with other row crops. We actually plant plants, the slips as they're called. When we do this, however, we have to open up a little trench every time one of those slips go down, so you're essentially disturbing the soil. So ideally, you'd like to put your Reflex, your Valor down, come in and after you plant would be great, but we can't because of the sensitivity issue. But you would like to not have that layer of herbicide disturbed as much as we can. When we do the transplanting activity, we do disturb that soil. So you have a little 2-3 inch gap on top of the row that is disturbed soil that a lot of times we have weeds break on through. Once we plant the transplant the slips into the ground, the potatoes into the ground, plants into the ground, then we have a couple of materials that we can currently use over the top. The one that is more commonly used and has been used for years is Command, and the other is Dual Magnum. Now both of these products are primarily grass herbicides. That's where they're most effective. They'll control most of the grasses, if not all of the grasses that I mentioned previously. They do also have some activity on some small seeded broadleaves, things like pigweed. Do a good activity, good job on. Dual will provide you a little morning glory activity. Has a little bit of morning glory activity, particularly on pitted morning glory. The Command is very good on grasses. However, things like purslane, which is another broadleaf weed we have issues with, some pigweeds, it can escape, not as good on. So the one thing that separates these two primarily, again, is the nuts edge. As I mentioned, the reflex has nuts edge activity before you plant, whereas the Valor does not. After you plant, the Dual has nuts edge activity, whereas the Command doesn't. So you have the opportunity to really have a 1-2 punch where you go reflex followed by Command right after transplanting to help you control your nuts edge. Now, we do have some flexibility also with the Dual Magnum in that we can apply it later in the crop. In other words, instead of applying it right at planting, we can delay it 10, 15 days after application, which is great because essentially what you're trying to do in any weed control program, no matter what crop you're talking about, is put your residuals out there, put your herbicides out there to where you can get the plants large enough to where they start covering ground. And you're taking advantage of Mother Nature's residual at that point, which is shade. So if you can get your good activity from one of your herbicides that you apply, Valor or Reflex down pre-plant, follow that up with, let's say, a Command or a Dual, and then follow up 10 to 15 days later with a shot of Dual where you've put Command down, you're limited the amount of Dual you can apply, then you can almost have a season-long approach to get you to what we call lay-by when you make your last cultivation, whatever, through the field, and your plants start covering the ground and you get shade out of it. Now, in addition to these particular herbicides, we also have a number of grass herbicides we can apply over the top. Now, those will control the grasses that emerge, and all of them are very effective on grass and do a good job of holding it back. But right now, as I mentioned, if you compare it to other crops that we grow, we're limited to about a handful of herbicides that we can apply. Tillage also comes into play where people like to go in and till and work up the ground, and that helps control emerged weeds as well. In a lot of cases, though, that breaks up that herbicide band, so you're disturbing treated soil, moving in untreated soil, and a lot of time you get a mixed bag. So where we have a hole right now in a weed management program is like that 21 to 35, 21 to 28 days after transplanting, where you could come in with something over the top that had good broadleaf activity and could knock out a lot of these broadleaves you have. Because you're relying on things you apply before planting and right at planting, and maybe 10, 15 days later to hold you throughout the season. You don't have a lot that you can come back with. There is a label for AIM herbicide to be applied. It's good on morning glories and some broadleaves. But you have to keep it completely off the sweet potato plant. It has to be with a hooded sprayer. It's a much slower operation, and there is the potential there if you get some mist or roll up from under those hoods, you can severely damage the sweet potatoes as well. So sweet potato weed management is as difficult or more difficult than other crops, obviously because of the limited options you have. But farmers have adjusted, and hopefully we were able to get the Reflex label through a couple of years ago, and now we're able to use it. There's another product, Linex, which is an old Linuron, which is an older product used in soybeans, that is currently in the IR4 program, which is undergoing review to possibly be included as an option in sweet potato. And again, that would be pre-plant application, but would give us something with a different mode of action, killing weeds different way than the Valor and the Reflex will do. So that'll help us from a weed resistance standpoint later on down the road. The limited amount of sweet potato acres that are grown right now kind of limit the new herbicide discovery that you have in other crops. And also, we don't have Roundup Ready sweet potato. We don't have Liberty Link sweet potato, Enlist, Extend sweet potato that we can obviously, transgenic traits that we can obviously just apply things over the top. So those are the options that we currently have. Most of the sweet potato producers in the state do a fantastic job of managing the acres they have and fighting the weeds that we have, because we have the ultimate growing environment for weeds here in the state of Louisiana. And that is my presentation on weed management. I'd like to thank the Sweet Potato Commission for the funds that they provide in support of my research.